I've been running like I'm about to miss a flight. And anyone that knows me personally knows that I do not like to miss my flights. I at least have to get to the airport 3 to 5 hours early so that I do not miss my flight. I've been running and 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 running since my past is persistently trying to become the dictator of my future. Now, I'm not one to hold grudges or harbor things like a pack mule, but I am one who can't hurry up because I have too much stuff. And it's because I claim too much baggage at my carousel, and I've been anxious to go through my accumulated suitcases and see what rags I've gathered over time. Suitcases consisting of items that allow me to play the victim. Unpacked unmentionables, not in the form of cotton, but situations I neglected to confront, like love and failed relationships, and acknowledging that I'm a glutton for heartbreak and singing sad love songs with a pint of ice cream in my lap. Let's face it, you and I are failing at the basics of a relationship. Partly me, because I never expect normalcy in a relationship, because my forecast is a bit different. I need the rain and thunderstorms every day, so I'll never see the sunshine, but I'll gladly embrace the humidity, the thickness in the air that weighs heavy on me like one of those anvils in a Wile E. Coyote and Roadrunner cartoon. You see, I never expect for the person I'm with to accept me. Hell, I can't even accept myself. A part of it is because of fear. Oh, fear. The fear of being open. The fear of letting go to let people in my life. The fear of giving too much of myself to a person and them not knowing what to do with it. It's always the pressure of love and relationship that causes me to sink like a spoon thrown in dishwater, and my breath is shortened by my own intolerance of the love people are trying to give to me. I've been running and 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 running. I've been running with my bag slowing me down. Because I expect to keep you at bay with my discarded luggage that continues to fall on my expedition. I expect you to proceed with caution like my skin is made of yellow tape, because you'll never see the contents of my luggage, my compiled excuses, my duffel bags of low self-esteem and insecurity, my carry-on of unmet expectations, because I won't let you. I won't let you. Not until I'm comfortable. Not until I'm done working on me for the betterment of us. Not until my bags stop holding me. Not at gunpoint or in customs, but by my own policy of holding on to the past, holding on sincerely to a greatness expiring soon. I'm comprised of intricacies. Well, at least that's what they're calling them nowadays, but I can't stand by idly and watch other folks be happy when I can have the same thing for myself, you know? So if you will, help me move these bags to the side, and maybe together, day by day, we can slowly unpack and put what we don't want to wear in our futures in a giveaway pile. And once I've accepted my baggage and you've accepted your baggage, then maybe we can get somewhere. Because let's face it, these bags have been holding us hostage long enough.